In my newest EDC video, I got a lot of comments asking how I use my MacBook and my Samsung Android phone together since they don't really share a first-party ecosystem. I can tell a lot of people, especially Apple users, are a bit worried about ever leaving their ecosystems because everything from texting to file sharing seamlessly syncs across and just works for them. Well, for me, even though these are Apple and Samsung devices, I basically don't rely on any of their first-party services. Instead, I lean on long-running, reliable third-party apps and services from other major companies. Ultimately, I don't really feel like I'm missing out on much at all, and I think this setup is arguably more productive for me. So let me take you through my own cross-platform ecosystem, show you guys how I make this Apple and Samsung combo work for my workflow, and maybe it'll be helpful for you too. Okay, let's just start with texting and messaging. I'm sure most of you know already, but for my fellow Americans out there, all the major messaging apps like WhatsApp, Line, or KakaoTalk all have excellent fully featured Mac apps that are super responsive and just work. So messaging and even making calls through these apps on Mac are no problem at all, so there is no disparity between the experience on my Android phone and my MacBook. If you are more reliant on SMS and RCS for texting, there's actually quite a lot of different options out there. But I personally like to use Google Messages for web since I know it's fully SMS and RCS compatible. I just have Google Messages set to my default SMS RCS app on my Android phone, install Google Messages for web as a web app on my Mac, pair them together, then I get all my phone texts, including SMS and RCS messages, right on my MacBook with real-time notifications, where I can reply, send photos and files, and if you have dual SIM cards, you can even select which phone number you're applying from. So on the messaging side, I'm totally covered. Then for my calendar and task manager, I don't use Apple Calendar, Apple Reminders, or Samsung Calendar. I simply use Google Calendar and Google Tasks. These two apps are conveniently bundled together, and unlike Apple or Samsung's versions, these apps are available on basically any device and browser simply because you can access them on the web or as a web app. Since they also rely on Gmail accounts and everyone has one, calendar syncing and RSVP PPs work so much better and faster. Tasks can have subtasks and due dates which directly show on Google Calendar. This is actually how I keep track and organize all my YouTube work across both my phone and laptop. And all this seamlessly fits alongside my personal calendar events, so I know what I'm doing on a certain day and what I have to get done. For browsing, I use Microsoft Edge instead of Safari or Samsung Internet since it's cross-platform and all my tabs and history sync across my devices. Edge is a Chromium browser, so it works just like Google Chrome and works perfectly with Chrome-optimized websites and even Chrome extensions. But the main reason I use Edge instead of Chrome or another browser is because of Microsoft Authenticator. Authenticator is my primary two-factor authentication service and password manager bundled into one. Two-factor code generators and all my passwords sync across my devices, and you can access the passwords via Edge or the Authenticator app. On macOS, you can even create a shortcut to it so it works like a separate passwords app. With Edge on my MacBook and Authenticator installed as the primary password manager on my phone, I can autofill passwords and also keep all my annoying two-factor authentications under one service, which is super convenient. Why I use Microsoft's solution here instead of others is mainly long-term reliability. Microsoft's main business is enterprise and B2B, and Authenticator actually plays a huge part in tons of businesses thanks to it being a big part of enterprise plans. So Microsoft is incentivized to keep this service alive for basically forever and keep it really secure too. For smaller password manager companies or other offerings from big companies like Google, I either just don't trust them enough to have enough resources to protect my data from data breaches, or their business goals just don't align with keeping the service going long term. Along those lines, that's also kind of why I rely on Microsoft Word and OneNote for document writing and taking notes. But the bigger reason is that since I don't need collaboration features, which I will say is better on Google Docs, I feel like the Android Office app is just flat out better than the Google Docs app for doing simple edits on the phone. You can access a lot more editing features directly from the phone, and it just feels more responsive too. And even though I am a big fan of web apps for document writing for long sessions on my MacBook, I prefer using a dedicated app. Having to use it in the browser, Google Docs just doesn't feel quite as reliable, and I can't afford to lose any saves if my internet goes wrong. Also, for note-taking, OneNote is available everywhere and is so much better organized and feature-rich compared to other note-taking competitors. It's super flexible, and I've been heavily relying on it ever since I was in school and still now for my full-time job. On the other hand, for spreadsheets, I actually prefer Google Sheets over Excel. For my type of spreadsheet work, I don't need all the super advanced features from Excel, and I prefer the simpler UI on Google Sheets. Just like how I rely on a mix of Google and Microsoft services for my office work, I do the same for my photos and videos. Since I have an Android phone and I take most of my pictures with this, the best cloud service for photos and videos is undoubtedly Google Photos. It works as the default gallery app for the phone, the prices are reasonable, you get Google Drive storage together with the photo storage, syncing is seamless, and I can easily access these files on my MacBook too since there is a website or the web app for Google Photos. It's also the best for searching for old photos through context keywords and super easy to have collaborative albums with a friend or family member. But for all my YouTube work, I like to keep all my photos and videos on OneDrive instead. This way, I can separate my personal photos and videos from my YouTube raw images and video footage of mostly tech products. This way, my personal gallery of family photos stay in Google Photos and they don't get mixed in with random pictures of a Xiaomi phone. Plus, OneDrive can be accessed in all kinds of ways, the web, an integrated Mac app in the Finder, and the Android app is really accessible too. I also use OneDrive for file sharing between my MacBook and Android phone for important documents and finance or government related things. It's just a lot easier to download and keep track of them under a protected folder in the cloud, which OneDrive does offer. For files that are much larger, like a bulk of 4K videos, I resort to a wired connection via Android file transfer. It's really not that great, but I guess it works since I don't really have to do this that often. With that said, there are conveniences that I wish I had between my MacBook and my Android phone. Since I got a good taste of how convenient AirDrop and QuickShare are, it really sucks that there isn't a reliable alternative when file sharing between these devices. There are options out there that people have made work, but they either have a relatively steep learning curve to set up, or they're just not that reliable and don't stay connected well enough. Even though using the Google Photos web app is perfectly fine for downloading photos and videos from my phone, having a wireless AirDrop option would remove that extra step of finding and downloading a photo on the laptop. What would also be great to have is clipboard syncing. There are also a lot of other third-party options for clipboard syncing, but for all the ones that I've tried, they seem to work sometimes and suddenly break for some unknown reason. I don't find too many people using clipboard sync that often, but it would be really nice to have when I just need to quickly share a link to myself between my devices. And finally, another nice to have would be using my Android phone as a webcam on a MacBook. I don't find too many regular users doing this. I myself wouldn't even do this that often no matter how easy it was, but it would be a nice to have considering that you can do this with an iPhone. In the end though, all these items on my wishlist aren't really must-haves for me personally, so I am very satisfied with this current cross-platform ecosystem that I've been relying on, and I don't feel like I have to switch to a single brand's ecosystem just to get those few additional conveniences. All the apps and services I rely on are all accessible on any device that I'm on or what I'm switching to, and I can log in and access them all through the web. Not only do I do this because I change devices all the time, I just think these are more functional, more featured, and just better services than the first-party ones offered by Apple or Samsung. But yeah, that's just me. Let me know down in the comments your guys' experiences and thoughts on this topic. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.